It all started a few years back. My doctor recommended I get a yearly low-dose CT scan to screen me for lung cancer because of my age and smoking history. At the beginning of this year, a scan showed that a nodule on my right lung was continuing to grow. I met with my pulmonologist who recommended I have surgery to remove the nodule.
There are many options for patients in terms of treating their lung cancer. The advances that have taken place in the last 20 years have really advanced what we're able to accomplish. Many patients are candidates for minimally invasive thoracic surgery, which is a way of performing surgery through small incisions rather than large cuts. Being able to make a few small incisions also means that we don't need to spread apart the patient's ribs to get to the lungs. And this usually leads to a faster recovery compared to patients who have undergone more invasive procedures like open surgery. There are two different ways to perform minimally invasive thoracic surgery: video-assisted thoracoscopic surgery, or VATS, and robotic-assisted surgery. In video-assisted thoracoscopic surgery, a tube called a thoracoscope is inserted through a small incision between the ribs. At the end of the tube is a small camera to guide the surgeon. The surgeon then removes lung tissue with specially designed instruments inserted through one or two other small incisions. The other type of minimally invasive surgery is robotic-assisted surgery. During robotic-assisted surgery, the surgeon sits at the console next to the patient in the operating room and controls the instruments, including a 3D high-definition camera. The instruments have wrists, which can move the same way my hand moves. The camera and instruments are placed through small incisions between the ribs. The surgeon removes the lung tissue through one of the small incisions.
When Dr. Bauer explained how the robotic surgery worked and that I would be a candidate, I felt very at ease. I didn't know anything about lung cancer before, but when I found out I could have minimally invasive surgery, I said, let's do it. I was really grateful my cancer was found early and that I was able to have minimally invasive surgery to remove it. I couldn't wait to get back into my garden. Within a couple of weeks, I was back doing what I loved and feeling pretty good.
Lung cancer surgery has really changed so much in the past decade. Surgeons are now equipped with minimally invasive tools and skills. If you're a candidate for lung cancer surgery, talk with your doctor about your options and ask if minimally invasive surgery is right for you. Visit the American Lung Association's lung.org for more information.